Hey guys, in this video we're going to talk about hosts briefly. So in terms of our local host actually. So there's two parts to this video. The first we're going to cover is the hosts file, and we briefly touched on that in a previous video. I think when we were deploying I think our Meteor application with Apache 2. We went into our hosts file to create some routes for the application. So basically, the hosts file is in etc slash hosts. So we can go ahead and open that up. Just type sudo nano slash etc slash hosts and hit enter. Put in your password. And this is our hosts file. So we actually did, we were in here for app.localhost, subdomain and Python. So the virtual hosts and Python deployment and the Meteor deployment, we were in here. And I didn't really explain to what extent you can use this file. So as I explained in the networking introduction video, a DNS server basically holds records of what domains point to what IP addresses. Think of this file as an internal DNS lookup functionality. So when I go to app.localhost, the first place my computer checks for a route is the hosts file. If it doesn't find an entry for a domain in the hosts file, then it goes out to the router and then your ISP and then a DNS server, and it checks there if there's any records for it. So by adding entries here, we can actually override default behavior of known domains that we want to change. So what I'm going to do is open up Firefox here for a moment, and I'm going to go to a website that will allow us to get the IP address of google.com, because we're going to be using that. So I'm just going to go to network-tools.com. And I'm going to type in here google.com. And we can see that this IP address is the one we are looking for. So I'm going to copy this here. And I'm going to jump back into this file. Now, this file can take three columns, and we've only discussed two so far. So let's go ahead and cover all the columns here in great detail. So the first one is the IP address that we want to route to. The second column is going to be the domain or the host name that we want to route to that. So let's just type in go.com. And then the third column is an alias, so we can just type go. And so when we save this file, what we're going to see is when we go to go, it's going to go to google.com, and their servers have actually they're not okay, so they're doing a lot of internal routing there. Let's try YouTube. So what we're going to do again, we're going to get the, actually, let's try something that we know is going to work. So I'm going to just type in my own server name here. I'm going to grab that IP address. Jump back into our hosts file. I'm going to paste that there. Now I'm going to save this again and go to go.com. It's saying it's not found. It's weird because this just worked.